Welcome to Friday's Cup here at Mexico. Late starting the broadcasting due to technical issues. And Front Row Racing DP will pronounce the name of the track for us.
Oh, cheers for that one, mate. You said you were going to give it a try. Welcome to FRR-idays at the Autodromo Hermanos Rodriguez, otherwise known as Mexico. So, this is a track that a lot of people don't know. A lot of people haven't done much running on, to be honest. But it could be a very interesting session here. With a lot of the drivers not really having driven much around this track, absolutely anything can happen here. Adam, I'm just checking, and it doesn't look like the live stream is on. Have you got it on your own live stream by any
No, it's on.
Oh, hold on, it does say that it might now be live, so I do apologise about that. Okay, so the Mexico circuit. I'm old enough to remember what this circuit was like in the olden days, when the likes of Nigel Mansell set the lap record around here with a 1:16.7. I don't think the drivers are really going to be getting close to that kind of lap time today, because of the changes of the circuit and not having had lots and lots of practice. I think given a couple of weeks of practice, then quite possibly. Over to you then, Adam, about this wonderful circuit and all of your knowledge of this fantastic racetrack.
Okay, what I know is it's in Mexico.
Well done. is that it?
No, the track length is 4.580 metres, and we have Andy Russell out on track at the moment with a sector one time of 23.804.
Now, I'm obviously, I am broadcasting on my own channel at the moment, and I'm actually on board with Andy Russell, and he looks like he's sort of just trying to get the car warmed up. I don't think he's really pushing to try and put a lap in now, either that or he had a bit of a mistake.
I think
I did not see.
In sector one, he was looks like he was setting a time, and then he made a mistake and he's pulled out.
Okay, but I'm now having a quick look at Michael Mulrine Lismore, Mulrine MUFC, come back to us after his lady has had a little baby, so congratulations to him on that one. It'll be interesting to see how he gets on at racing while there's a baby screaming out down his ear hole and the wife saying change that nappy. I mean, I'm not a parent, Adam, so what's it like as a parent trying to get your racing done?
Extremely hard. It's not easy, especially when you're trying to balance family life, but it's easy for me because I'm rubbish at every track, so I take to it like
That's
a duck to water.
Well, ducks take to water very well, but there we go. Okay, now, would you like to comment about our latest addition on the FRR-idays roster?
Yeah, we welcome Jade. She's a solid driver, very clean, and she's looking forward to getting involved with FRR-idays Cup. The thing is, with Front Row Racing, anyone's welcome to message the page, come and join the Friday's Cup. Just have a bit of fun, get to know what you're doing, put in some decent performances, and you never know where it's going to take you. But she is the first female driver in the league, and that says something about Front Row Racing, that it's attracting all types of drivers, and anyone's allowed to have a go, and we welcome that.
I agree with you. I mean, at the end of the day, when it comes to gaming is not just a male dictated genre, so to speak. At the end of the day, it's one of those situations where both males and females like Formula One. And if they're into gaming and racing and they want to get involved in a league, then there's absolutely nothing to stop them from doing so. Although, what I will say is, this is a message to all of our current league drivers, behave yourselves. Just because there's a girl in the league doesn't mean you can flirt with her, chat her up, or put her off, which is what would more likely happen. But there we go, so be warned. But yeah, I mean, you mentioned to me about Jade a couple of days ago, said it's someone that you've raced with before, or you've known about before. And I do think it is good that the league is open to having anyone race, basically. As long as you race clean, then there's a space for you on the track.
And I suppose the positive thing is that Front Row Racing have actually beaten the real F1 in allowing a lady to have a race seat.
That is very, very true. That is true. Well, I did find it quite amusing that with F1 recently, they were going on about how, Susie Wolf could be the first female F1 driver, and then a load of people were like, well, hold on a moment, there was a lady in the 60s or 70s or whatever it was that actually was the first. But we have been the first to get them on the track before the real F1. Okay, I'm just having a quick look at the timing screens. Michael Moonline has gone and stuck it on pole position with a 118.3. He's literally just done that. And he might still be on another flying lap. Stocky's in second place, 0.2 behind him, with pole behind the both of those. He's about 0.8 off pole at the moment. Then Killer Corcoran, Andy Russell, Ray. Ray has taken to the racetrack. He must have got bored in the pit lane, and he's figured he may as well get on the tarmac, and rightly so. And then we've got Jade. She did say that she was doing a bit of practice, because hadn't really driven here, and was getting around about the 120s, which isn't really that bad of a time, to be honest. Okay, I'm riding on board with Michael Mulrine, but on your main broadcast they might not see that unless you ride on board with them as well. If you want to mention about who you're viewing, we can always go from there.
I'm on board with Paul, aka Farfber, and he set a sector 1 time of 22.783, sector 2 28.963. But what I'm noticing with most drivers that I'm seeing is that as the lack of knowledge of the track, they are struggling to stay within track limits. But that's part of the learning process of the FRR-idays Cup. You're allowed to learn, you're allowed to make mistakes.
Well, I mean, that's something we should always really emphasise, in that with the World Championship, the World Series, we have stewards that will take additional action on drivers that are off track too much. But in the FRR-idays, we don't do anything. We have no involvement whatsoever. We just let the drivers get on with it. If they are off track way too much, then their chances of becoming a reserve driver are limited. But it's somewhere like this, it's Mexico, the drivers haven't really driven there. We could get a bit of a benefit of the doubt. And also this week, it's sort of a one-off, where it's a case of, usually with race at the tracks that the leagues have raced at, but because the leagues ended up a week behind, we've thrown this one in as a little bit of a special here in Mexico. So it counts, but it kind of doesn't really count, if that makes any sense. I hope you'd agree with that one. Okay, I'm on board with Jade, who's about to start a flying lap, so I don't know if you want to quickly get on board and we'll see.
Yeah, I'm
how
on board.
On. Okay, so heading then up to turn one. Now, as I said, I'm old enough to remember the original layout of this circuit and what a track it used to be. Obviously, a lot of the corners have changed a bit, and I don't like these really tight first sort of two and three corners, as Jade doesn't either, as she's struggled a bit through there. But as we said, it's to be expected on a track that a lot of the drivers do not know. And also, I mean, I do remember the older version of the track, where it literally was tarmac and grass. It was so much easier to actually see where the track was going, because there was grass next to the track. Like this section we're here, it was tarmac and grass. so you could tell where the track was because it was the only bit you could really drive on. Now, a few of the drivers are going to struggle through the whole of this circuit. We're just going to let it go. When it comes to the league races here, different kettle of fish. Okay, so Jade's coming through the fantastic final section. I say fantastic, I love the stadium section. I just don't like the bit of racetrack that's before it. It's a nice right-hander into a horrible section of corners. They could have made it a much, much better section of corners, a very fast section of corners, which would have been much more attractive for the viewers.
All right, I'm on board with Moraine MUFC 91. He's on the option tyres, sector one time of 24.465, currently in second position. And yes. My pick for first in quali today, a sector two time of 30.267.
Well, Stocky's gone and taken pole with a rather good lap time. I only caught the last corner of it, so I can't comment on how good a lap it was, but in time-wise, it's a very good first lap. Not first lap, pole lap.
And Mulrain pits.
Can I have a quick... Sorry, go on.
Mulrain's pitted, he abandoned the lap.
Oh, that's a shame, because looking at the timing screen, Mulrain's actually got a faster sector one. But Stocky's gone 4 tenths quicker in sector two and 2 tenths quicker in the final sector. So that's where his lap time has come from. It's the middle and final sector. And they're kind of the really tricky ones. Okay, quick message to my viewers. I'm only really live streaming this for the moment to help promote the Front Row Racing live stream. We are broadcasting live on Front Row Racing's Twitch channel for FRR-idays. And you're more than welcome to jump over onto their Twitch channel and watch that live stream there. As I said, I've only got mine on here to help promote that. Okay, so we've got 5 minutes left of the session. Do you think anyone's going to challenge Stocky for that pole position?
Well, I think Paul will. He's on his outlap. He's just entering the last few corners on the option tyres, so I'm going to ride on board with him. Just gone over the start finish line in the first DRS activation zone.
Okay, I shall keep an eye on the sector times of 22.70.
He's approaching turn one. He's taking it very nicely. Turn two, turn three, a little bit of a cut. Still looking good, no lockups. Into the second DRS activation zone leading up to turn four. He's arriving up to turn four, takes it nice and early, into turn five, a little bit early, a little bit of a cut. Into turn six, straight on the power, no issues there. Go past it, a slow moving car, no issues there, car moved over. Into seven, eight, nine, leading out of 10, into 11, nice bit of work in the S's section from Paul. Going down to corner turn 12, taking it nice, a little bit too deep, a little bit wide, into turn 13, tight left-hander, into turn 14, and turn 15, he's taking it a little bit too tight.
A little bit too much curve.
Just a bit.
Yeah.
And he crosses the line with a time of 119.658, currently third.
I think he'll feel that he can do better than that. He may have improved on his lap time, but he was a bit off in each sector compared to current pole sitter. Okay, I mean, if we look at the sector times, fastest sector one is a 22.7, current slowest is a 24.2, so there is a bit of a gap in that first sector. But, I mean, some drivers are just quicker than others, and some drivers are new.
Right, on board with Killer Corkin, he's starting his fast lap on the option tyres. DRS wide open, leading down to turn one. Just see if there's any issues. He's late braking into turn one, taking the corner very nicely into turn two. Turn three taken nicely, a little bit wide on the exit of turn three. Going down the second DRS activation zone. Nicely braked.
I'm on board with Andy Russell at the moment. He's had a very good sector one time. Sector two could be good. He's trying to keep it nice and clean. He's a driver I would like to try and keep an eye on this week, because he's been determined to get onto the reserves list for the last few weeks, but a bit of bad luck he's not been able to. Okay, back over to yourself.
Yeah, on board with Jeff, aka Killer Corpen. Seemed to slow down a bit through the S's sections. Don't know if that's a bit of a lack of confidence going into there, or if it's not the right setup for him. He's entering the last bit, the complex bit, with the stadium near the finish line. He's going into turn 15. He's gone wide. I think that's going to cost him. That's cost him about 0.5 of a second, maybe a bit more, into the last corner. He's currently fourth. He sets a time of 1:22.576, staying fourth. A last sector time of 28.948.
Yeah, that last sector time would have hurt him quite a bit there. I mean, with the sectors, there is a bit of a spread in sector one, but sector two, it's only a second covering the whole of the field. Sector three, again, it's only 1.2 seconds covering the whole of the field. So sector one seems to be where most of the time is being gained or lost. But I mean, here's something to consider. Obviously, we did the Bahrain races last week. The track temperatures and the way the car behaved, cars behaved at that track, will be very, very different to how the cars will behave here. Now, this, I think, is a track that's going to tempt people into going extremely low downforce because of the very long straight. Now, yes, you'll get fantastic straight line speed, but there is a hell of a lot of corners around here, and at the end of the day, you need downforce to get around those corners. So it could be a tricky track when it comes to setup, getting that right balance of speed and the cornering. Some drivers, looking at sector one, may have gone for more aerodynamics, which is why they're losing a bit in that first sector. They perhaps just need to work out how to gain a lot of it back in the second and third ones. Well, I'm still riding on board with Andy Russell at the moment. He's still pushing to try and improve, but I think his tyres have had it. He's now backed out of it, the 23.9 sector one. But I think for Andy, all Andy needs to do is spend time on the track. That's it. The checkered flag has now come out, so we're into the last moments of the session. The drivers are only going to get to cross the line, and then that will be it. Paul has worked his way up to second place, so he has got ahead of Killer Corcoran. I wonder if we've got anybody else on track. Mulrine, he's in third.
On board with Frontrow Racing RI, just behind Mulrine. He's currently sixth position, and he's gone up to fifth.
Oh, so Ray's done well to sneak up a bit then. Just watching back on the live stream, they were quite close, weren't they? So Ray may have had a little bit of DRS advantage. I'm currently watching Killer Corcoran though come through the final sector with one car ahead of him. Killer currently in fourth place, and whoever's ahead hasn't improved, otherwise Killer would have dropped a position. And Andy Russell has backed out of it and into the pit lane. So that's pretty much it. Session over. So, who do you reckon is going to go and take the win?
I'm going to go for Stocky.
I'm going to go for Michael Mulrine. I think Paul and Stocky are going to get into a battle, take each other out, and Mulrine's going to go and win it.
Do you think there'll be any issues leading into corner one? Long straight.
Oh yeah, Ray's driving, of course there will be.
He may have had his iron brew, may have got the skill.
Possibly, but I know he's listening because I can hear his microphone clicking on and off. I'm waiting for the response to that comment. Silence. Unless it's your microphone, Adam, but I can hear clicking on and off.
Could be the wires.
It could be. Drew, hello. I send you an invite into this because I didn't know if you were interested in getting involved in the Front Row Racing FRR-idays events on Fridays. It is a way of getting into our leagues, becoming a reserve driver for our league. So if you do want to race here, you are welcome to do so. you should be able to put a setup on because part of Fermate is not on. But if you're not able to race next Friday, you're more than welcome to join in on the Fridays if you're interested in partaking in some events. And for anybody else that's watching, whether it be on the Front Row Racing live broadcast on Twitch or on my own Twitch channel, if you are interested in joining a league, just send a message to Front Row Racing NW on PlayStation. You can send them a load of messages. Or find Front Row Racing on Facebook and send us a message on the page. Just say you would like to get involved with the league. You then take part in the Front Row Racing FRR-idays events. Drive clean, you can be a reserve driver for the World Championship, which is a no assist league, or the World Series, which is an assists allowed league. Once you become a reserve driver, drive clean, drive fair, do well, and if places become available permanently, then the opportunity will be there for the admins to say, right, this person deserves the chance, we'll give them a go. Okay, so we've got 15 seconds then to the start of the race, Adam. Anything else you want to add?
It'd be interesting to see in race mode how these drivers are going to attack the track, because qualifying is different. There's no pressure now. They've got the cars around them. I'm just going to see how they attack, how they defend, and how they can handle the pressure.
Okay, we're on four lights, five lights. Arriba, arriba, andale, andale. And they're away. I better not retire too quick, otherwise my car may crash into everybody. I think that might be what Adam's just about to do. Okay, so as they're away then, heading up into turn one, we'll see if we can get on board. It looks like Paul has managed to work his way up into first place, ahead of Stocky. He's got some straight line speed, or just had a very good start. But then we've got a Williams sandwich in a Mercedes. The stock is fighting back into turns four.
Oh, is there contact?
And on the inside, and there was contact. They'd get a bit fighty and end up taking each other out. It's coming. It's coming. You know it is.
A little bit of friendly contact, shall we say.
Oh, yes. Okay, I'm going to have a little bit of a look a little further down the field. So I shall let you discuss what you may be seeing up at the front.
At the moment we have Stocky first with a 3/4 advantage. Paul has just gone past Moraine. I think Moraine went wide. And it's allowed Killer Corkin into third, so Moraine is now fourth. They're all separated by about a second. It looks like Moraine might have just got past Killer.
I think he just had a moment. I managed to see it. He's side by side with Killer Corkin heading down that main straight. But really, you don't want to be side by side. You want to be slipstreaming. But there we go. Yeah, they are having a good battle. But I'm just at the moment keeping an eye on Jade. She's got a Ferrari of Andrew. I can't remember his surname. Of Andy ahead of her.
Andy Russell.
That's the one. Yeah, so she's got a Ferrari of Andy Russell ahead and got Ray behind her. That's a sandwich you really don't want to be in. And, there's so much debris in the air from the trees I've just spotted. You know those, like, little snowflake-style bits of fluff you get that just appear out of nowhere? I've had loads of them in my flat over the last few days, but going down one of the straights where the trees were, there was just loads of leaves and those kind of debris heading down the straight.
An interesting battle between Moraine and Killer Corkin. They seem to squabbling over a few corners, which is leading to near contact. But I think they're actually holding each other up now and allowing the rest of the field to catch up.
Oh, Ray's just made a nice move on Jade, but then he's outbraked himself and Jade's gone back ahead. A nice bit of driving by Jade there. She could see that Ray'd got the move done and just let him outbreak himself. They're going to be close heading into the final section. But looking on mine, I'm going to go and have a look a little further down the grid. I think Killer Corkin looks like he's about to make a move. On Michael as they head into turn one.
Got pushed a little bit wide. Killer had to take a bit of defensive action there. He's still close, a tenth away from Moraine. He's side by side.
I think he's going to get past him. This is one of those tracks where you can have the the right line for one corner, but it could be the wrong line for the next corner coming up. I do think this is a track where, when it comes to the league races, we could potentially see a lot of overtaking going on, as these guys are showing at this moment in time. Okay, so Killer has got back ahead of Michael then. And Stocky's still ahead of Paul. Looks like he's pulling out a bit of a gap on him. But it also does look like Stocky's car is jumping about a bit. I wonder if someone's phoning him up and he's going to lose connection any moment.
Go on, someone phone him.
Make him disconnect two races in a row. He will not be happy.
Stocky looks like he's losing a bit of time. Actually, Paul's closing up on him. About 3 tenths behind him now. Going down a start-finish straight.
Paul did gain a lot of him in those final few corners, and I think he'll have DRS here as well, easily catching and gaining. Can he make a move though? He can't, but Stocky's had a moment, and there's the contact.
Oh, there's contact, Paul's gone.
I think Stocky's been able to keep going, but I did say that there would be contact between those two at some point. I don't get everything right, but I was right on that one.
Paul's going to be a little bit mad under that crash helmet there.
He quite possibly will be, but he's now got Killer not very far behind him. It does look like Stocky has backed off, you know, and sort of let Paul catch up a bit, because either that or Stocky did spin as well, but the gap between them is not that big. So I do wonder whether Stocky did kind of go, oh, right, we've had a bit of a coming together, I'll back off a bit.
I think you may be right there. I think Stocky eased off a little bit, which is nice to see.
It is. I mean, when it comes to the league races, Jade's off track at the moment, gone very wide. Tyres could be struggling. I think she may have actually started the race on the prime tyre. She has. She's gone brave. And I've just had a look, an up-close look of Michael Mulrine's tyres. And oh my God, they look terrible. They really do look bad.
Paul's got the DRS. He's side by side with Stocky leading into turn one. He's got past Stocky. Stocky's got the inside line. Oh, Paul's just got the outside, then he's gone inside, then he's gone outside. Stocky's still behind him. There's contact. They've touched.
Contact
Stocky
again.
Touched his front wheel. Stocky's still behind him.
I thought he was going to say Stocky touched his front end, rear end.
Stocky's managed to late brake and get past Paul.
It did look like Paul may have backed off a little bit there, sort of repaying that compliment of, okay, we've had a bit of contact, I'll give you your place back. And I was about to say as well, when it comes to the league races, right, when you're on track, if you make a mistake and you crash into someone and you knock them off the track, then what we tend to, well, what we say is, if you take it into your own hands, back off, let the person either catch back up to the position they were in, or like if they were behind you, then you let them catch back up. If they were ahead, you let them get ahead of you. The stewards will make no judgment on any of it. They'll let it go. You dealt with it on track. But if you crash someone off and just run off down the road, that's when they'll get involved and look at implying penalties. Now I think Paul's going to be going for another overtake here, Adam.
I think you're right there. He's lining up Stocky's right beside him. He's going to take the inside line. He's looking for it. He's trying to get in front of Stocky. He's managed to do it a little bit. Yeah, I think it was a little bit of a lock-up by Paul. Stocky's trying to recapture the position. I think Paul's gone a bit wide there.
Mulrine has pitted, put the prime tyres on. I've also got a Ferrari in the pit lane. Jade's continuing on with her prime tyres. What tyres has Andy gone to? He's on the options, I think, but it's not letting me view him at the moment. So we have had the first people in the pit lane who've now gone onto the prime tyre. So they've got 11 laps to go. That means that Jade will be wanting to go to about lap 8 or 9 before putting those option tyres on.
And Paul's still in front of Stocky by about 2 tenths of a second. Stocky's closing right in. He's getting in the slipstream of Paul. Paul's just gone a little bit wide there. They're into the tricky little complex near the end of the lap. Stocky's 2-3 tenths away. He's trying to stay close to Paul. I think he's going to have DRS. Paul's gone a little bit wide on the exit. Stocky's DRS is wide open. He's going to try and attack. Try and get slipstream from Paul. Stocky's lining up the move.
He's surprised he wasn't able to get ahead a little earlier, to be honest, down that straight. I thought with his straight line speed and DRS, he'd have got ahead. But these two battling, it's allowing Killer Corkin to catch up, and that's exactly what he's doing. Now, Richie Davies just sent me a message asking how Andy Russell's doing. It's not letting me view him at the moment, but he's getting beaten by Jade, although Jade does still have to pit. To be fair, when I was watching Andy Russell in the qualifying, he wasn't overly fast, but he was keeping it on the track. Oh, Paul's had a moment and Stocky's all over the back of him.
Riding on board with Killer Corkin, who's just lapping this up. With Stocky and Paul fighting, Killer's just getting closer and closer and closer. It's going to help him.
I could see all three of these pitting this lap. If the front two don't, I think Killer Corkin should. Because if he does, he'll get an undercut. So are any of them going to go for the pit lane? Yes.
Yes.
Stocky does. Killer does. Paul doesn't. Paul's going to suffer here. Okay, I'll let you commentate on what's going on there. I'm going to have a quick look down the rest of the grid.
I'm on board with Jade at the moment in sixth position. She's coming round to the last few corners. She's gone a bit wide. Maybe her tyres are suffering even though she is on the primes.
I've just seen Mulrines had a big off into the stadium section. He's recently pitted and put his prime tyres on, I think.
Well, Jade's made contact with the wall.
Final section.
Jade touched the wall a little bit, but she seems to be okay. She's coming down the pitch straight. She's in fifth.
Doesn't seem to be any damage on the car, so she's got away with that one. And got Andy Russell behind her. So Jade's gained in the pits. No, Jade still hasn't pitted yet, has she? She still needs to make a stop. Okay, quick look up the front on mine then. Where's Stocky come out? Come out in second place still, with Killer Corkin all over his rear end. See, I was not surprised that some of them pitted on that particular lap. Really, Paul needed to pit as well. But obviously, with him being the lead car in that pack, he had the choice, pit or don't. Whereas the guys behind, they had the choice of perhaps doing exactly what the car ahead does or doing the opposite. If you're in front, you don't get that choice. You just pit or you don't. Okay, so has Paul chucked it into the pit lane? He has. He's only just getting to the end of the pit lane now. I think he's going to lose out quite a lot here.
Oh, I've got a brilliant camera view. Yes, brilliant camera view there of all the cars coming down the pit straight. And Killer's going to have Paul as well.
He is. Unless Paul's going to get aggressive into turn one, but his tyres are going to be cold. You did have a brilliant view. I didn't get that view going down the straight. That's not fair.
That's the magic touch of the Londoner.
Oh, yeah. Now, Michael Mulrine actually looks like, although he had an off, it looks like he may be catching up to this pack now. His pace has started to come in a bit by the looks of it. Now, Jade in fifth place, I'm on board with, still hasn't pitted. Has been struggling a little bit around this track, but she did say she doesn't really know this track and hasn't really practiced here, which is why she's going to be off track as much as she is at the moment. But to be honest, I mean, she could pit now, and really I think she needs to with the state of those tyres. The best thing she could do is throw it into the pit lane, put on a brand new set of options and see how she gets on for the rest of the race.
Paul is right close to Killer Corkin. Near side by side coming out of the last corner on the start finish straight. Paul's slipstreaming. He's gone to the side of Killer Corkin. He's second place now. I think he's got DRS, he has. He's easy pass on Killer Corkin there.
Now, Paul will be hoping that he's got the speed in those tyres. Oh, he's ran wide, though. I was about to say, he got the speed in those tyres to catch up to Stocky, but he went wide at turn one, which meant he messed up turn two and three, and Killer Corkin's gone straight back past him. I mean, this is something that I think a lot of drivers will struggle with at this track, because it is now very much a rhythm circuit. You get one corner wrong, you're getting three or four corners wrong. It's not just a case if you get one corner wrong, oh, that's one corner wrong. And I also think there's the possibility of, around this track, with some of the wiggly sections, if you by accident do an ETL on one corner, it's going to lead you into an ETL on the next two or three. And that's where drivers are really going to have to back off quite a bit to keep it on the road. At the end of the day, driving these Formula One cars is not meant to be easy, and the track shouldn't be either. Paul's having a big wiggle. He nearly ended up in the wall there, and that's allowed Killer Corcoran to get ahead. Well, not get ahead, to pull ahead a little bit more.
I think with the squabbling between Killer and Paul, it's allowed Stocky to get at least a 2 second gap, it looks like.
Jade's got Andy Russell all over the back of the car. I'm glad I worded it that way. She still hasn't pitted. She's pushing these tyres as long as she can. But Andy Russell is in DRS range, and Ray is also not far behind. He hasn't got DRS.
And Andy Russell's made the move.
He's going to be getting in a place soon. Andy has made the move. A nice one into... or heading up to turn one. Oh, Jade's taken way too much track there, but definitely struggling with setup and tyres.
Has Jade not pitted?
Pit lane again. As far as I know, she hasn't pitted yet. She started on the prime tyre, and I think she's still going, which is why she's struggling as much as she is. She would be much better off now, if she hasn't pitted, changing those tyres. I mean, I did try having a little look a while ago at the state of the tyres, and they do look fairly worn, to be honest. The front right has got a lot of different colours.
Oh, she's gone well wide.
Those tyres have absolutely had it. I think she realises it now as well. I've got a feeling we'll be seeing her in the pit lane at the end of this lap. Ray is ready to make a move.
Jade's had a wiggle again
with the racing lines there, but I mean, when your tyres are knackered, sometimes the car does go where you don't want it to. She's going to have to take it into the pit lane.
She's carrying on.
She's carrying on. Maybe she has pitted then. She's just struggling. Okay, let's go and have a look. I'm going to have a look out at the front. Stocky's pulled out a nice healthy gap now. Paul's got himself up into second place, so we've missed it, but he has got ahead of Killer Corcoran.
Oh, Killer's had a messy slide. Exit.
He did, yeah, a messy exit. That sounds like the day after a curry. Yeah, so we've obviously missed it there, but Paul's got ahead of Killer, and the gap has grown a bit. Paul's got five laps now to try and catch up to Stocky, but he's ran well wide. I've got a feeling, you know, that these prime tyres are just not very nice around this track, or the drivers have gone very aggressive on their setups and they're not quite perfected yet, or they've gone very aggressive on their setup and their prime tyres don't like it. At the end of the day, when it comes to setups for the tracks, I mean, there's a few ways you can look at it. You go for just straight outline, fastest straight line speed, and do your best in the rest of the track. But you could lose massive chunks of time. You could go for just getting a very nicely handling car on the option tyres that gives you a very solid fast lap time. Or you could do the better option of the three I'm going to give, and that is set your car up for the prime tyre.
Just to interrupt, Jade's not pitted again.
Oh, she's still going then. We'll have to find out afterwards whether she did pit or not. Yes, okay, so option three, set your car up for the prime tyres. Because if your car handles well on the prime tyres, you've got a good car. And if it handles well on the primes, it's going to handle even better on the option tyres. The lap times will just come to you if you've got a car that handles well on the prime tyres. I mean, of the seasons where I've won championships, that's what I've done. Pretty much solely set a car up on the prime tyre, because that way the options take care of themselves.
All right, okay, I'm on board with Front Row Racing RI, Ray, and Andy Russell's right behind him, a tenth or two away in sixth position, challenging Ray after Ray had passed him. And Jade is amazingly still hanging on to the back.
I was going to say, Ray was behind Andy a little while ago, so Ray has perhaps caught up and got past, or Andy has had a moment somewhere. I've got a nice view of the front end of that Ferrari then. Now this could be an interesting little battle here. I mean, I know Andy is very interested in getting in the league.
Oh,
he's had a wiggle. He did have a wiggle.
That was a very messy exit from the car. Is it possible the track's just not hot enough?
It could be that the track's not hot enough, or it could be that the track is too hot.
And Andy Russell has made the pass with DRS.
He has made the move. He's compromised through two and three, so Ray's still all over the back of him. But, interestingly, Andy's got DRS in the second DRS zone.
Oh, lock up into the corner. Ray may capitalise on this. Andy Russell's gone wide. Ray looks like he's going to go side by side. He's trying to go tight into the corner. Andy Russell's still got him covered.
Now, Andy is on the option tyre here, and Ray is on the primes. So, I think Ray's just a little bit quicker.
Oh, Andy Russell's gone wide.
He's had to back out of it. He's cost himself a position there, but I like what he did there. He went wide and he backed off. You can't fault a driver that does that. I mean, when we look for reserve drivers, I mean, this is a very difficult track. And even if I was racing, to be honest, I mean, I wouldn't say I'm not the best in the world, or far from it, but I like to think I can keep a car on the racetrack. If I was racing in this race, I would not be keeping the car on the racetrack. It's just one of those circuits. It takes time to get it absolutely spot on and keep it on the road. Okay, Andy's got DRS. He's going to be going for a move into turn one again.
Oh, he pulls out very late. He goes side by side. He's into fifth. A nice move by Andy Russell.
Now, is he going to compromise his turn two and three again? No, he's managed to keep it together. Ray's right behind him. And I think Ray may have DRS here. He's up alongside. He's got.
Oh, it's a lock up. Oh, Andy Russell had to pull out a little bit to avoid contact.
Oh, he had to pull out, didn't he? what was I going to say? Yeah, I didn't realise that there was two DRS zones here, so it's interesting there that if a couple of times we've seen when a driver has gone from moving to turn one, they're losing the position in the second DRS zone. So overtaking here is going to be, you're going to have to kind of do it quite cleverly. Now Ray's fighting his position hard here on the prime tyre. He could perhaps do with a little bit of a breather, but Andy Russell's giving him a little bit of a nudge. One thing I was mentioning about was, I mean, I expect the drivers to be off track here a lot. It's Mexico, it's to be expected. We didn't give the guys a lot of notice that this is where we're racing. But it's what they do while they're off track that I'm finding interesting in this session.
And Andy Russell's made a move. Looked like there was a bit of wheel rub in there. Line.
Yeah, oh, Ray's had a big lock-up. And he's sideways drifting that Mercedes round turn two. Now, he's going to get potentially DRS in the second zone again, but I don't think he's going to be close.
Andy Russell had DRS.
So I'm wondering whether whoever gets DRS for the first zone also gets it for the second zone. Rather than there being
yes,
two
there's
detections.
One on the circuit guide. There's one detection zone between just Ooh. Near turn 15.
You're right there. Yep, there's one DRS detection and two DRS activations. That's a little bit cruel, really. Unless they realised that when altering this track that if they had a second detection, then a car would get passed and then just get re-overtaken. Okay, so Ray has, it looks like he has managed to catch up a little bit, and I'm just going to go and have a little look at the rest of the field. Stocky's got a nice healthy lead at the moment. Paul, I think, is pushing to try and catch up, but can't do so at the moment. Bit of a gap between him and Killer Corcoran, who's still there or thereabouts. If Paul has a mistake, Killer's going to gain. Michael is probably about 4 or 5 seconds off Killer Corcoran, not that far away.
And Ray's made the pass. Battle. He's got past Andy Russell in the first DRS zone at the end of turn one.
So Ray should have DRS here then, which should allow him to stay ahead. DRS open, but I think Andy's going to go for the move up the inside. They've given each other just enough room into the very difficult section, and now a double right-hander, which I'm going to call the U-bend. Oh, I didn't even realise it was on the last lap. Stocky's won. Well done.
I tell you what, Andy Russell and Ray's driving there was brilliant.
It was, yeah. Giving each other plenty of room. Now, I've mentioned it a couple of times in the video. Andy has been wanting to race in the league for a while. And the only reason he's not gone to the reserves list is he missed a couple, got disconnected from a couple. Oh, he's had a big wiggle. But from what I've seen of him in this race, yes, he's been off track a bit, but he hasn't been off track as much as quite a few of the others. When he has been off track, he's kind of done the right things. I thought he was going pit lane then. That was a big slapper on the final corner, and it could nearly cost him a fortune. But yeah, so I've been impressed with Andy's driving there. So anyway, Stocky takes the win, and over to you, Adam, for the final moments.
Yes, Stocky takes first place, Paul second, and Killer Corkin third place in a very good race with battles up and down the field, especially between Stocky, Paul and Killer Corkin in the first part of the race, and then Andy Russell and Ray in the later part of the race. But I'd like to thank everyone for tuning in to Friday's Cup. And remember, just message the page, you've seen the action, you want to get involved, just give it a go, you never know where it's going to take you.
That is very, very true. Well said. I mean, that was a race of sort of two sort of major battles, really. The first half of the race and the second half of the race. Now, it does look like Jade has been disqualified from the race, which is a shame.
Received multiple penalties.
Yeah, that's what it'll be for. I mean, I'm not going to worry too much about that one, because at the end of the day, I mean, we've had spoken to the drivers, and it's a very difficult track. I mean, in the FRR-idays, we don't take any further action. Okay, anyway, I've been Front Row Racing DP. Thank you very much for watching on the Front Row Racing live broadcast, and also on my Twitch. If you have been watching on mine, feel free to not watch mine, and on Wednesdays, Thursdays and Fridays to watch the Front Row Racing live broadcast. That's on Front Row Racing Twitch channel, and the videos will also get put up onto YouTube. So I'm going to bring my broadcast to an end in a moment, and I will hand back over to you, Adam, for the final words. I've been Front Row Racing DP. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you soon.
I'd like to add to that. It was a good event. The drivers didn't know the circuit, and they did very well considering the circumstances. Next week is back to normal business, in line with World Championship and World Series track. But a great job by all the drivers, and I'm Front Row Racing, and I'll look forward to seeing you next week. Thank you and goodbye.